In this video, I want to talk about fuses for your 12-volt electrical system. Namely, what they're used for, how to spec the proper size, and where to install them in your system. And let's dispel a few myths while we're at it. Let's get started. Hello all, and welcome to Sparked Ed, formerly Showtime SPL. I'm Eddie. I got a few of my buddies over there watching. And if you're new here, please consider subscribing as it really motivates me to make more videos. Now, for the first time in a long time, I actually wrote a script, so I'm going to be checking some of my notes from my other phone down here. Okay, so fuses. You may have a project in your car, truck, UTV, SUV, camper, boat, whatever it is that uses a 12-volt electrical system, and adding those electronic accessories would require you to add wire and fuses to that wire. The problem is that many people are unsure of how to select the proper size fuse or wire or even where to install it in that system. There's a lot of misinformation out there also. I see at least once a day posts being made that spread misinformation and demonstrate lack of understanding of the topic. So with this video, I hope to clear that up and give you the tools necessary to spec the proper fusing for yourself, no matter what the install is.
Yo, dog. That fuse has to protect your amplifier from damage.
Okay, so here's an important myth that we must address. You see, the real purpose of a fuse is to protect the entire circuit that it's connected to, and an amplifier certainly is part of that circuit. However, an amplifier does have its own internal circuitry with many branching pathways. Now, some lower-end amplifiers do feature some built-in fuses, and what they do is really protect that power supply stage from internal shorts. And they don't have much other protection besides that. But higher end amplifiers do. They have smarter protection. They can sense faults on the output stage as well as the input stage. So they are very well protected. Now, an external inline fuse only offers a thin veil of protection. Like it would only really protect from one type of uncommon failure, which is shorts right on the power terminals of that amplifier. Let's say if you slip with the screwdriver while hooking it up or something like that. Now, what a fuse is perfect for. A fuse is a designed to fail device. So if that power wire that it's connected to were to ground out, it will fail and it will sever that connection and stop current from flowing. Now imagine this. Okay. You have a high-end audio install with big amplifiers, batteries, high amperage, alternator, and all this power wire run through the car. Now let's say some not too good of a driver T-bones you and you're in a collision. Now the sheet metal of your vehicle bends and pierces that power wire. Well, without a fuse, now the positive post of that battery going through that wire is touching right to ground and sending full current capability of that battery to ground, and it's gonna combust. It's gonna heat up that wire in the sheet metal. Now the fuse will break that connection, stop current from flowing, so it is perfectly safe and we want to use it.
Right. So how do we choose the proper size fuse? Well, it's tied to choosing the proper size wire. And we choose power wire based off of the demands of the load and how much current we have available. And then we choose the size of the fuse also based off of the demand of that load and how much current actually can flow through that power wire.
Hey, yo, boss. Supposed to size up that fuse to the amp's power level. So you got a 1,000-watt amp, divide that by the 12 volts, got yourself an 83-amp fuse.
Oh, no. See, this is another myth, and we gotta talk about this. See, you can't spec protection for a circuit based solely on the maximum potential load of that circuit. And the line, the power line, isn't always going to an amplifier. And even then, an amplifier can fail even when it's at low volume and not drawing its full maximum potential current. Fuses are needed wherever you have power wire run. You need it in between an alternator and a battery and a battery, battery and an amp, battery and a distribution block. And a distribution block will then split to multiple different legs of a circuit, multiple circuits. And each one of those legs needs its own fuse. And you need to determine the maximum current draw that's going to be on each of those legs so you can determine your power wire size to be able to feed that. And then you can choose your fuse to protect that particular wire. And each leg of that gets its own fuse, gets its own protection. Now, something like this, for example, the FBX12 is a fuse distribution block. So it takes in large current power wire and splits it to multiple circuits. And each of those legs can be individually fused. You can change these fuses out and choose them properly depending on the current demands of your accessories and the circuit that you're connecting to this.
Jamming out here. So the Cadence speakers are performing very well. These custom pods I built a few videos back. But the last video, I did a contest where I'm giving away one of these Pro X 6.5s and an excess power battery meter. And the winner, I have them right here. The contest was to guess what color I'm going to paint my car. I gave a hint, it's going to be Plasti Dip and a pearl. A few people guessed blue pearl. They're in the right range. Someone said an alien pearl. It is an alien pearl. It's not specific enough. We had, I think, 3 people that guessed right. So I randomly chose one of those people. And there it is there. Brandon Dinesi. He said blue purple color shift. And although that's not the paint code, I wasn't looking for that specific. He guessed right. That's it. So the correct color that I am going to be painting my car, I actually already did, but not showing the video yet, RL71 Alien Pearl, which is a color shifting pearl from Plasti Dip that shifts from blue to purple. And I'll show a little close-up video of my hood right here so you can see the actual color. But the whole project and the whole car, I did ask for comments for people to vote if they wanted me to show it now, the whole car completed, or wait for the build series. And I believe I had more votes for building it up, showing the build series, and showing that in the end. So let me show you the prizes over here, and then we'll be getting back to the video. So here we have our lovely prizes. Of course, previously mentioned, the Cadence Sound PXM6. This is a 6.5-inch mid-bass woofer. Sounds phenomenally accurate, as well as sensitive and efficient. Will be great in door builds, speaker pods, or towers. And then we have the Excess Power / Sparked Innovations battery meter. This can be adjusted for AGM batteries, lithium, ultra caps. It can display voltage or percent of charge and can be turned on and off with or without illumination. It also snaps into the housing of several batteries. Not this battery I have here, but there are several battery monitors that this will snap into. If you go to sparkedinnovations.com, you could also see that we offer switch panels, and we can incorporate this meter into a switch panel that you can then mount on your dash. With this prize that Brandon will be getting, I'll be throwing in a single mount for him. He could snap this in anywhere he wants, or he can screw it in using our mounting plate. Thank you, Sparked Innovations. Thank you, Excess Power. And thank you, Cadence Sound.
So let's discuss where in the power line you would install a fuse and what applications require them. Well, it is suggested by me, but also by industry standards, to install a fuse close to any power source or any junction point. That means when you have a battery, any wire coming off the positive post of that battery should be fused. Your alternator, being a power source, should have fuses off of it. Or anytime you have distribution, like a distribution block for big power wire, or like what we have here with this with the distribution slash fuse box, the fuse box in the car, if you're doing an OEM thing off of relay switches, anytime you have a new source or branch of power, you should fuse it there. Man, you ain't need no fuses at all. Besides that, those car manufacturers, they ain't putting no fuses on the alternator or the starter anyway.
Actually, this is quite false. You see, the Society of Auto Engineers had set federal standards for ground vehicle electrical systems using fuses or fusible links in between any power source and their load. Now, historically speaking, auto manufacturers have chosen to use fusible links in between the battery, alternator, and starter. However, these do go unnoticed amongst most do-it-yourselfers because they don't know what they look like. A fusible link really is a smaller piece of wire in a cable designed to burn up above a certain current draw. And so it just looks like a normal cable and goes unnoticed to most people. Now, most modern vehicles are now choosing to move over to regular types of fuses in the actual fuse box under the hood of the vehicle.
Thanks, Edwin. Yes, it is safest and best practice to fuse any power wire close to the source. Now, my car here is not standard. The factory battery was in the back, and there are a lot of people in their applications are doing battery deletes and relocating a battery to the back. If you are doing that, it is best to have a fuse by that battery. You're going to want to run a new wire to carry that current, especially if it's for high-end audio gear and you have a bigger battery bank in the back and a high amperage alternator. You want to run probably multiple lengths of wire like I have here, and you want to have a fuse holder in the back by those batteries and in the front off of the alternator. All right, hopefully that clears up some information for you guys. Thank you so much. Feel free to ask questions down in the comment section below, and I'll try and get to them. And share this video if you find it helpful. Share it on the pages on Facebook, on any other social media and things like that. I would greatly appreciate that. And remember, may the bass be with you.